Good morning, girls. This is teacher Felisa. Welcome to another week of our English session. Before we start, be sure to have these following materials with you. Your book, your pen, and your notebook. Today, we shall be having a letter from Birmingham Jail. You can see this and you can open your student anthology book on page 310 to 317. At the end of this discussion, you are expected to discuss segregation, explain the events that led to Martin Luther King's arrest to Birmingham Jail, and analyze points made by Martin Luther King in his letter. I encourage you to pause this video first, go to this link, and watch the short video clip. Now, what is segregation or racial segregation? It is a separation. Take a look of the word separation, okay? It is a separation of humans into racial groups in daily life. Example of these separations are eating in a restaurant, drinking from a water fountain, using a public toilet, attending schools, and going to the movies. So based on these five examples, before, during the time of Martin Luther King, there is a separation between the blacks and the whites. So that is what we call segregation or racial segregation. What is it all about, this letter from Birmingham Jail? But before that, we should be familiar first with Martin Luther King. Who is Martin Luther King, or MLK? He is an icon to America's civil rights movement. He accepted leadership of the first Great Negro Nonviolent Demonstration of contemporary times in the United States, the bus boycott. And his home was bombed, put in jail, and held to days of personal abuse. But at the same time, he emerged as a Negro leader. These are his history movements. He traveled over 6 million miles, and because he was a famous orator, he spoke over 2,500 times, appearing wherever there was injustice, protest, and action. He also directed the peaceful march on Washington, D.C. of 250,000 people, whom he delivered his address, "I Have a Dream." So what is his dream? He dreams of equality. Equality between the white and the colored people. Lastly, he was awarded 5 honorary degrees and was named Man of the Year by Time magazine in 1963. Let's go now to the content of the letter. Martin Luther King stresses these two things on his letter. First is equal law, and second is fear of violence in future. So let's have a deeper discussion on it. By the way, Martin's main message on his letter is freedom. He stresses that let freedom ring. First thing he pointed out is equal law. Now, King Luther King questions how people could be arrested for nonviolent movement. Second, he agrees with St. Augustine's principle, an unjust law is no law at all. And lastly, King does not feel that they have broken the law. His answer to the clergyman is that all law that is not morally sound is not a law. He also stresses fear of violence. Now, he ended up his letter by saying, past promises have been broken by the politicians and merchants of Birmingham, And now is the time to fulfill the right of all people to be treated equal. Because of taking a courageous action, many considered King's letter from a Birmingham jail a turning point in the battle for civil rights. So girls, this is just the gist or the summary of the letter of Martin Luther King from Birmingham jail. I urge you to read the whole content of the letter on your student anthology book. And try to answer this essential question on your notebook. In Letter from Birmingham Jail, how does King explain the purpose and effectiveness of nonviolent direct action? That's it for today. Thank you for listening.